Over the past few years, I've been lucky enough to work within the urban music scene, and I have watched it transform from an underground genre to one that has recently achieved number ones and top tens. But even though I've worked with artists across rap, grime and Afro Bashman, the genre which has really took a hard hit in has been drill music. Come on, YG's talking Brexit. That's no more Red Light District, no more subtitles on Netflix. The plug said it gets expensive. Checkers 2.0, no confidence, hope, but it ain't interested. Man can't budge and fix when it comes to the strip. When I first started the filming process of this documentary, Drill Minister had just emerged onto the scene. A controversial artist who challenges politicians and those within the government. So I decided that it was only right to visit his studio in southeast London to see what's happening behind the scenes.
Politicians' words should be not just looked at more deeply, but a lot of people in a lot of positions who are apparently authority or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
You see it? And we need to look at that because I think society wants to judge man more than try to understand man. When you're seeing political drilling, that's more than music.
Yeah.
That's art. That's something that when man's dead and gone, they're still going to be able to quote that at this political time when a madness was happening in our country, someone stood up against the government, innit? That's a fucking V for Vendetta thing. So that's what man's trying to do, innit? Mm-hmm. Man's trying to make massive changes and make the kid that's 8 years old right now say, rah, when I was eight, I saw Drill Minister take on the whole government
mm-hmm.
on his own for the culture, for what he believes in. Like, if he's willing to do that, I'm willing to do something.
Yeah.
And then they can maybe be Prime Minister and make a difference mm-hmm. or whatever. Team A! The moment is coming when the knife gets heated. Twist. Stuck in the front and twisted. She'll be dead soon. Can't stop breathing.
During the filming process, I was asked to join a panel discussion surrounding the topic of legal action against drill music, and sat beside me was Drill Minister.
I think if it's within a creative aspect, then a lot of things people should be able to express within their own way. Obviously there's certain boundaries and everything, but if it's a way of like pushing beliefs onto other people, I think it's different.
And so that's part of the difficulty. So yes, you have a right to say what you want, but there'll be consequences for that if you say something. Cops STAD and tugs and both of them push your twins. Last game made young T with swim. Up block settings on violent things. I'm going equipped, pads and whips, hands on hips. If Jeezy tripped, then he would have been pissed. If Jeezy tripped, then he would have got dipped.
It's no surprise that the mainstream media are against drill music and have arguably used it as a scapegoat. However, The Guardian have really shed light on the topic and on those affected. So I caught up with Kieran Thapper, who recently wrote an article on the situation.
Where we're sat right now, I work with Marcus Lipton Community Centre, which is in Loughborough Junction. If you speak to a lot of young people at the moment, drill has provided a voice and a way of being visible.
Mm-hmm.
I think where it becomes problematic is when you then like, That music making process is part of a back and forth of like making something worse,
mm-hmm.
Being provocative. I'd still say though that the music making isn't the problem; it's the mm-hmm. social media. I think what's interesting about Skinned and AM is that actually they tick every box of being like, you know, well branded.
Mm-hmm.
They've got decent management. They've got a whole team backing them.
Yeah.
They sell out shows. You know, that they're a really, really good example of what music and drill music in particular can actually allow people to do very, very quickly.
At the beginning of this year, two of the most loved artists in drill, Skengdo and AM, were sentenced to a 9-month injunction by the Metropolitan Police. I had also noticed that in the majority of interviews I conducted, Skengdo and AM's situation came up in conversation. So it only seemed right that I spoke to TK and SK, who managed the duo, to get their side of the story.
Hi, I'm TK. I'm one of three directors at Finesse Forever, which is a record and management label.
Hi, my name's SK, one of three directors at Finesse Forever, which is a management and a record label.
The media
the media and the Met Police, actually, with the statement that they put out, doesn't even talk about what the injunction actually was. Most of the stuff that's actually in the injunction is already the law. A lot of people don't know that. Example, you don't get into gang activity, not committing crimes. That's already the law. Do you know what I mean? But they just made the complication of drill music.
Yeah.
They didn't put in the headlines that we're actually allowed to perform drill music. We did a show the next day. Where we can put out tracks. We're putting out track.
Coming next week.
Do you know what I mean? So it was a way for them to kind of disrupt their live presence. And obviously that disrupts their income, do you know what I mean? Which I think is a very weak response.
They just did it to kind of make other upcoming artists that are doing drill music kind of scared and like wary about doing it, to maybe stop the whole influx of drill artists that's coming through. The fact that even with the injunction, they couldn't even pin a crime on them that they've committed. They couldn't pin a crime, do you know what I mean? What the crime that they've got a suspended 9-month sentence for is because Link Up TV, the same thing that you're doing right now, is documenting. Link Up TV documented a whole 24 hours with Skane and AM on tour.
Which is not their fault.
And Link Up TV published the video.
They're trying to make it, if you do drill, you're a certain type of way. No, bro. There's no difference between a murderer can be a drill artist, a murderer can be a person singing about angels.
Yeah.
That's due to the personality, not the music.
What song has actually created a murder? What crime can you pin to an actual track? You can't do that, because even a lot of these tracks are done months and maybe sometimes even a year before something on the streets has even actually happened.
Skender and AM, we use them as an example. I've been listening to their music for years and years now. What they're rapping about 6-7 years ago to what they're rapping about now, they throw things in like, you know what I mean? I want to live with my bros. I want to make my family proud. They weren't talking about family in that 5 years ago.
You want to talk about drill, but why are we not talking about the rock bands or the punk bands?
Yeah.
Like, I wanted to give an example of a rock band called...
Misfits.
The Misfits. And they got this song, you can check it out, called Last Caress. And it's talking about raping a baby, domestic violence. I killed my wife today. Got people singing, do you know what I mean? These guys are critically acclaimed artists that's selling up.
But you're not going to blame them for the rapes and the crimes. You can't blame them.
Why? And what's the reason? It's all systematic, do you know what I mean? It's bigger than just music and
it's down to the individual. Like, do you know what I mean? A lot of people say, yeah, you're promoting. No, bro. It's down to the individual.
Throughout the planning process of this documentary, I reached out to many UK politicians and MPs. After being declined for interviews multiple times, I finally had a positive response. Florence, a member of the London Assembly for Lambeth and Southwark, agreed to meet me in her office at City Hall for a chat.
I wouldn't say that there's a direct correlation between drill music and violence. Why I say that is because if it's your first time listening or watching a drill artist, whether it's performing, whether it's their music video, whether it's clips online, you may stand back and think, oh, you know, is this what I want my kids or my peers or I want to be listening to? But I'd say stand back, strip back some of the images you're seeing, strip back the fact that they may be in hoodies or they may be in masks and, you know, some of the signs that they might be doing, but listen to the lyrical content. I think what I'm worried and concerned about is... some of the links that the Met Police are saying they've seen with some artists in terms of goading other artists and other, you know, other artists from different areas, for example, which they then say has led to fatal stabbings or shootings. I think what I would want some of the artists to maybe hone down on is some of the gestures and then I have seen a few videos where they have brandished weapons.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I think, you know, that that then detracts from their music. So that would be my only plea to some of the artists in their videos. But equally, if there are real threats being made, and it's a case of they can be linked back to an organisation or group or a particular person, then, you know, I would want the police to be taking that seriously. But I'd say, you know, it's about... if the police are able to get access to the lyrics, they should be able to get access to the young people behind the lyrics. And you know, sometimes it could be just be a misunderstanding. And so I'd be wanting the police to have that discussion before jumping to conclusions. I wouldn't say it's moral panic. I think because it's new, because it's taken off, because it's got such a wide following, and because obviously now, where, you know, generation we live in, there are so many different avenues to promote that. So whether it's Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, you know, Facebook, that's why it's getting more prominence. Whereas if you go back to the days of, you know, when hip-hop rap came out or heavy punk rock, all of that wasn't around. So it didn't come on people's radar as much. And then, like I said, you throw in the visual side of it with the music videos that people are making. Again, that gives it that different edge where people may... The fear of the unknown, probably. I'd prefer if a group of 20 to 25 young people were in a studio making music instead of them being out on the streets. We should welcome that. So from them making music, they could be able to actually earning legal money as opposed to selling drugs.
Yeah.
This is something that we should welcome. So we need to maybe try and give them tools to, you know, how to explore and address other things. Because they're talking about the issues they're going through now, but we know there's so many other issues. There's mental health, there's access to housing, access to jobs. If they were talking about all those other things in other areas, maybe it would help me and other policymakers and other politicians in how we address some of those things.
Yeah.
So I think it's because there's always this fear of what you don't know and the unknown and something new. And maybe in about sort of 5 to 10 years, we'll look back when drill has and grime and Afrobeats and all those other genres have really blown up. And we'll be looking back and thinking, so what was the panic all about?
Yeah, exactly.
Anyone that's familiar with the urban music scene will be aware of GRM Daily, one of the biggest urban music platforms within the UK. Having supported drill music from the get-go, they also felt the pressure from local authorities. I caught up with Alex Griffin to explore his feelings on the subject.
There's too many success stories already. Like, obviously, it's all part of rap music, right? It's been around a while. But in terms of drill itself, it's not been around that long over here. Even in America, it's only a sound that's been like, I don't know, 10 years tops. I guess music's always a kind of a reflection of the world around it to some degree. But yeah, it's just another form of that kind of expression. Like I said, rap before this, the old garage stuff. Like, you know, people have been talking about the subject that's discussed in drill on other types of music. It is censorship. Like, I think it's ridiculous. It's putting a plaster over a gaping wound, you know what I mean? You're not solving anything, you're not addressing any issues about why these things are going on. You're just essentially turning a blind eye to it, I guess. Like, we can't see it anymore, so it's gone away. Like, that's not the reality. Especially Skengdo and AM, obviously they've had a pretty high profile dealing with the police and that sort of thing in terms of their music being suppressed. And yeah, like, it affects people's livelihoods, you know what I mean? These are guys that have toured the country, they have thousands of fans. Yeah, they're doing something positive, and the police are just kind of preventing that from happening. But there was a point where, at GRM, we were kind of... I don't want to talk too much about it, but we were feeling the pressure, shall we say, from essentially the police via YouTube. YouTube are actually very supportive of kind of drill and free expression. But they're under pressure from the police.
At the beginning of this documentary, I set out to find why drill music is portrayed so negatively and blamed for so many crimes. And although it's difficult to pinpoint one specific reason because there's no proven cause and effect, I found that social media is a big factor in this, as we as a community come to terms with how information is perceived on the different platforms.